Thanks everybody. Thanks Barry. Thanks Martin. Wonderful. I'd like to introduce Barbara Miller, who is the VP of Consumer Marketing Solutions at Sony, and she's going to come on up, Barbara. She's going to talk to us about, you know, how Sony Electronics sees video, how they deal with it, and how they bring multiple divisions together to execute in the space.
Thank you.
Take it away.
So today I'm going to tell you about a campaign that we call Brand Voice internally. If we can stay on the slide. Okay.
Just tell
me
what to go back.
There's a lot of things going on up here. All right, so we did a campaign that we launched in January that was very unique for us as a company. Sony has a lot of entities, as you probably are aware of. How many of you actually own a Sony Electronics product? Not PlayStation. Okay, and how many of you have seen a Sony movie recently? How many of you know that Sony actually has a movie studio? All right, and then what about on the television side? How many of you watched a Sony picture television program and know that that's where it came from? So one of the things that we've been trying to do overall as a brand is really bring this one Sony message to the consumer so that they understand that we're not just a manufacturer and a hardware consumer electronics company, but also that we are a content creation and we own the content components of the entertainment factor of the brand. So in doing that, we've launched a campaign that we called Brand Voice. It really is focused on how we as Sony move forward as a united entity and not as separate siloed sister companies. And we call it Be Moved. And it was really about how do we accomplish a way of bringing more relevance to the brand, to really identifying that we were an entertainment entity, and then how do we show that differentiation of being both entertainment and hardware together in a day where content is king or queen. We work with Wieden and Kennedy out of Portland, and we also work with Universal McCann, which is our media agency of record. So here's our challenge, and this is a lot to see. Looking at, you know, what we consider two of our biggest competitors in the electronics space, Apple and Samsung, it's really about what people see the brand as, and what we found is that Sony overall is kind of a faceless brand in the electronics space. People didn't know how to describe us. They knew that we had quality products and that we had good product. However, they didn't necessarily see us as innovative and relevant for today's economy and today's competitive landscape. So what we looked at is how do we then, as I said, bring all of the brands together and look at the portfolio that we have of product and of content and services and bring that into a space where consumers would understand what we do when we create new product. So we launched the campaign looking at left brain, right brain, right? How our engineers actually go about creating new products and the artistry that goes into the innovation of new technology within the company. And we created this One Voice Be Moved campaign. So as we look at the campaign, one of the things that we wanted to do was really change the conversation about Sony. And changing the conversation meant going into places that normally, from a media perspective, we don't spend a lot of money going into, such as social and more digital. As well as using traditional media avenues like broadcast. So we really wanted to talk about how do we create this brand story and change what the perception was of the brand and build that out through contextual video content. So going through the creative strategy. You look at this, the spot that we launched initially really talked about the foundation of the brand and how we were founded, so really focusing on the engineering component and how we were an engineering-based manufacturing company, but then building on that across sister companies. So we identified key electronics products, but we also related those products to one of our sister company properties, whether that was Sony Music, Sony Pictures, PlayStation, Sony Network Entertainment, really telling the full breadth of the brand and in the story. And I'll show you the spot in a minute. We then looked at the customer journey and what we wanted to do with the whole campaign in general. And that was to drive this inspirational brand feeling through to engage the consumer on our hub. So we created a digital hub that we drove most of the traffic to, and then get a conversation going in the marketplace around the content that was being generated both on the hub and in social space. And then we looked at a full spectrum of what the media buy could be and should be. So looking at different touch points that we wanted to activate on, we started and kicked off the campaign with the Golden Globes, and then taking that big burst and amplifying it through social media channels and other digital buys, including conversational components like Gawker and BuzzFeed, to get people talking about what they saw and what the brand could do for them. The campaign is still in market, so we'll be running the campaign, at least the first phase of the campaign, through the end of this month. So some of the data that I have for you is not complete because we haven't finished this first phase. But wanted to bring out some of the points of engagement and how that the campaign started to come to life from a digital perspective. We bought a lot of pre-roll. We did 15-second, 30-second, as well as 60, and our broadcasts were 90-second spots to engage and really get folks paying attention. We also did cinema, and I think earlier we talked about cinema and how you're really getting an audience that's not sitting in front of the TV in the weekend, but actually sitting in the theater. So really to augment and amplify what we did in broadcast. And then we also looked at our own channels. So from PlayStation Network to our own Facebook page, we spent a lot of time stoking the conversation on Twitter. We had a social war room that we ran during both the Golden Globes, and then we did another big broadcast burst at the Grammys, focusing on some of the key Sony Music artists that were being represented during that particular time frame. And then YouTube, right? So for every piece of video content that was staged during the campaign, that content went up on YouTube. And we drove traffic to YouTube and then from YouTube to the hub. So a lot of masthead takeovers during the campaign, as well as position search placement and banner and display advertising as well. So here's some of the creative that we represented. And as I said, we went through and identified some of the key products within the electronics space that actually had more of an artistic, inspirational story behind them. So I'm gonna show you a couple of spots so that you get an idea if you have not seen it yet. So if we could start with the brand spot.
The engineer and the artist. They usually live in different worlds, but when they work together, well, that's when you can get something really new. Something special. Because when great thinkers work with great doers, 1 + 1 can equal 3. When you hear the sound of coming, hear the call of coming, I want you to join together with the band. It's the singing, not the song. The mix of music moving on.
Oh, got your set.
Play PlayStation on your own time. We're trying to shoot a movie here.
I'm sorry, Sprite.
All right, sound ready? Slate in. Go.
Since we began, our artists and engineers didn't set out to make electronics or films or music. We set out to make you feel something.
So one of the things, you know, being on the electronics side, it was important for us on the electronics side to see what type of product lift we could get from this campaign, even though we really focused on the whole house Sony as a brand and One Sony as a concept. So what we found as a result of airing this, the Golden Globes, is that nobody knew that we had an underwater Walkman. So I'm going to show that spot next, which actually was the spot from the beginning of the campaign that drew the most attention, it drew the most search, it drew the most actual product sales from the campaign, and we really didn't go into this measuring sales because it was really about the brand and the voice of the brand and how we changed the concept of what Sony was as a brand. So if you play the next spot, please.
When we told the world we'd invent the Walkman, they laughed. When we told the world we'd invent the CD, they scoffed. When we said that we'd invent MP3 headphones to play music underwater, they said,
so that's an example of how we really tried to pull out little tidbits of what was going on in the 90-second spot to make it more relevant and to break it down and use it across our digital channel. Separate Together, which I'll go into in a little more detail, was also very different for us from a brand is around starting a conversation. So Separate Together, which let me get through some of this first, is about Norlands, and I don't know if you're familiar with Norlands, because I wasn't familiar with Norlands. Norlands is the world's largest miniature train sort of environment that one guy decided that he was gonna build because he had nothing better to do. So he's got a cave, he's got mountains, he's got people, he's got a lot of little miniature things going on that if you really have the time, you should go and look at it. We did a full documentary, and we shot it using our QX100 lens, which attaches to your cell phone, or you can actually attach it and sync it, and then take the lens and place the lens, you know, up to a certain distance away from you, and then control what it does from the cell phone. So it was really a good experiment in how to use the lens camera, but it actually got huge following online from a social perspective. So we wanted to talk really about, again, how the conversation was changing and whether or not this campaign was working because it was so different from what we had done in the past. And as you can see from the initial launch, people loved it. People saw that it was very different. They saw it as innovative. They saw it as something that as a brand we should have been doing a long time ago. And so we continue to try to build on that and look at how we were measuring things. We went from being very rational and almost mechanical to now having more emotional components come out when people talked about the brand and when we followed up to see how the campaign was resonating. We also got great press and we got great earned media based on the conversation that started. So far, campaign's doing well. The other thing that, and we talked a little bit earlier about measuring the brand, and we measure brand recall and message recall. In this particular case, the baseline was what we do during the holiday. So looking at our holiday campaign, which is more a promotional message, a product message, we saw huge lift in just what we're getting back from people resonating with what they heard about the brand, and then really building on the message that we were trying to create, which was this message of One Sony, and also a message of Be Moved, which if any of you attended CES, Kaz Hirai really talked about creating this wow, and from his perspective, what that wow meant to him as a long-term Sony employee, but what the wow meant for what we put in the market and how we want the consumer to see us as a brand. So as I mentioned on some of the smaller digital 15 and 30 second spots, the Separate Together, which is the Norlands piece, actually did the best in click-through rate to the hub. And then also the Walkman W was also one of those that really outperformed the other piece. So we did a kickoff of Norlands on Jimmy Kimmel Live, where Jimmy actually played the documentary for his audience, and Guillermo opened. So if you watch Jimmy Kimmel, Guillermo provided quite the little intro into the spot. And then the QX100 lens went through and picked up different components of Norlands as part of this documentary, and then we took that and then broke it down again into 15 second and 30 second spots that we seeded through social. So overall, to date, the campaign, as I said, has been very successful. We've got 4.5 million YouTube views across all of the content that was put out there. We've got good pickup off of Jimmy Kimmel because he then reposts everything that he puts on his show, so we've gotten good take up. We've got a 71% video completion rate, which was something that we had never seen in any of our other campaigns where video content had been used. And then we also made, you know, we had this real success rate of the conversation going forward and going on. So with a million total total views and posts from BuzzFeed. We also did a couple of contests. So if you go to the hub, within the hub, we actually took all of the hero products and they're digitally put together. And I wanted to show you that, but it's kind of hard to see it come together on this type of display. And the products as they come together, one of the things that we did was we hid little things in the product build and then went and did a Twitter contest where you had to go back, look, and find things that were part of the product. So for instance, in the camera, we actually have a piece of cheese. And so we did a contest where you had to go find the piece of cheese and then tweet that you found the piece of cheese and at what point of the video the cheese was in there. So there were a couple of contests like that that actually got really good engagement and really good pickup. So as I said, we haven't finished. We still have a couple of weeks left in this campaign, and what we'll be going forward with next is an underwater app store. So we'll be launching an underwater app store with Google, specific to the Sony Xperia Z phone, which is waterproof. And with that, you'll get apps that you can put on your phone that will work when you dunk it in water. So we're really looking forward to the conversation that comes from that. It's a very innovative idea. It hasn't been done before. It's not easy to get into the Google App Store and get your own app store. So we've been working really hard on that. And I'm hoping that you guys will definitely go and check it out. So any questions on anything that I've presented? I tried to not spend a lot of time in the data, but the deck will be sent to you, so you'll have an idea of some of the things that we measured as we were going through this campaign. Yes?
For your umbrella campaign, so brand, who is your target audience for that different than the product campaign?
Yes. So in our segmentation strategy across the company, we have a target we call the digital entertainment junkie. And the digital entertainment junkie is really a digital native that consumes both entertainment content and is also a tech enthusiast. usually skews 18 to in that 18 to 34 range, and usually skews male. Any other questions?
I think we just ran out of time.
Yeah, I think we've got to get. Thank you, Barbara.
Thanks
very much.